Hello, I'm EnterElysium, and by popular demand, we're back in From the Depths, and we're going to do a campaign. So, you may have seen me play From the Depths before, you may have even seen my stream. So, From the Depths is a game about, if you didn't know, building vessels out of blocks, and then fighting other vessels with these vessels. It's, on a simplistic level, that, but it's actually a lot more complicated in how it goes about things, and it's really kind of cool in that you can have a lot of customization. The campaign, you have to, like, mine resources, and you have to take over parts of the map and fight other factions who will come and try and kill you. And you have to try and defend yourself, gather resources, build more ships with those resources, with each, you know, block costing resources. It's kind of really, really awesome. No hint of a lie. I really love the idea of the campaign in this, because it's strategic at the same time as you've got so much interaction and, like, customization, creativity can go into it. It's really my ideal combination for a game. So we're going to go new game. We're going to do Quest for Nita, which is like the default campaign. I think you can like make custom campaigns for like custom factions. So like I could make a faction called the Elysian Empire that would have like really awesome ships and you'd have to fight them. And by really awesome, I mean horrifically derpy, as I do. So we're going to be playing the Quest for Nita, the default one. Difficulty modifier, I think one is fine. I'm not new to the game by now. I've got a lot of hours on Steam. I've only had it for a week or whatever, but you know. My mic died. I had to do research. It's an excuse. We also played a stream of it the other day. Enemy growth factor 1 seems fine. Resources given to player. I'm going to reduce that. It's on 0.1 at the moment. And I think, like, 0.4 is experience. So I'm going to put it at 0.7. Does that seem reasonable? 0.6? 0.7? I'm going to go 0.7. An enemy design difficulty, we're going to leave it on regular. If we get killed, hey, it's a learning curve. That'll be fun. And you can press M to go to the map. You can go F1 to go to the diplomacy screen. And E to control your forces. Okay, so am I good to go? I'm good to go. Begin new campaign. And boop. Okay, so this is our starting fortress. You may notice it's not the most amazing fortress in the world. In fact, it's kind of made out of wood. And it has lightweight alloy blocks along here, which is complete waste, and we're totally going to rip them up, because they cost a lot. It's got a little gun up here, which is awful, and I'm controlling it. Go, don't be controlled by me. Oh, it looks sad. Yeah, it's a really terrible gun. Like, if we have a quick fire of it... Yeah, you're awful. I'm going to kill you. If we go down here, we've got, like, a... tractor beam docking station, respawn vehicles and scrap fortresses and structures, and spawn new vehicles and fortresses. Okay, so this is like our dock. Which looks kind of like a dock as well. This is our resource gathering. So this like gets us scrap, natural, metal, and crystal. Problem is there's like no crystal here to be mined, so we're not getting any. And I think these over here get us oil, which we turn into like fuel. Over here, we have our engine bay. Which is a horrific engine. In fact, it's really terrible. It's really terrible. We should replace it pretty quick. In fact, if you look at our power, which is like bottom right. It's the one with the little power symbol. We only got 81 out of 288, so we haven't got much power left. And if we're going to build on this, it's going to get heavier. It's going to need more power to stay afloat because it is currently, if I unhook the camera, floating. We also have a little boat here, which is awful. No weapons. Not very highly powered. It's dreadful. And in fact, we're going to scrap it. So, vehicle scrap and respawner. No, I don't want to edit the sign. No. I would like to edit you. Starting rib. Scrap. Boom. And destroy scrap object completely. So we've got the resources back from that. So you can see like at the bottom of the screen, our resources are ticking up. Which is excellent. One thing I will do is start ripping off bits of this fortress so we can make better stuff. So we don't start with that many resources, and this fortress is actually pretty poorly made. And, you know, I know I'm saying that, I'm pretty new to the game, but it's kind of got a waste of resources in quite a few ways. Well, if you're wondering, by the way, what's in that metal bit, that's our ammo supply. Ammo explodes. So I'm going to take away some repair tentacles. The reason I'm doing that is that they use crystal. So watch our crystal. It goes up. And we need crystal to make crystal. Crystal, like, you can mine it, I think. But the the other way to get crystal is you can like breed crystals in effect. Like you're not breeding them, but you like put them in a tray and they multiply. So if we get a few more crystals, we can grow crystals quicker. I'm gonna leave most of the rest of the stock intact. I'm gonna get rid of the cannon. I'm just flat out gonna get rid of the cannon. Yeah, you're no good. Also, I'm actually gonna get rid of. I think I'll get rid of most of this wooden top bit, because the wooden top bit, like, if it gets shot through, which it will do. Are you still floating there? Really? Okay. To edit a turret, can I? Yeah, that turret is actually destroyed. It's just floating there for some reason. Okay. Fine. Float here if you want. I don't need you. Ah! Let me go down. I'm going to take this platform out so I can at least get some resources back from it. Boop, 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 and down. By the way, I completely got the tactic of deleting the repair tentacles for more crystals off of Avak. He's a Let's Player who, there we go, has done From the Depths a few times, and I've totally picked up that off him, so don't worry, it's not my cunning plan. Totally stole it. So, by the way, you know that looks like it's crashed down there, and like I've wasted resources, and like stuff's just sitting around? You do actually get resources back. Like, you can see that our natural resources, which wood is made from, are ticking up now. That's because this is actually, like, destroyed. It's just, like, debris right now. So we did actually get the resources back from that. And if we go over here, you can see this metal stuff. This is actually a different shade to that metal stuff over there. And that's because that's metal. This is lightweight alloy. And if you want to see something absolutely crazy, metal block. Health 200, armor 10, weight 0.4. Armor alloy. 125, so it's a lot less health. Armor 7 as opposed to 10. And the weight, an eighth. So it's really light. In fact, I think it's lighter than wood. Yeah, oh my god, it's half the weight of wood. However, metal block. 5 scrap, 30 metal. That's pretty easy. 10 scrap, 60 metal, and 10... Is that fuel? No, sorry, it's 10 natural, 60 metal, 10 scrap. So yeah, that's a lot more expensive. And it's not as protective. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rip out all this, because I've better stuff to do with this, right? I can use it to make more metal to defend my base. I didn't mean to put... God damn it! Stop placing things! I should probably put a mirror line down when I'm doing this, but it's too late now. Now, if you're wondering, by the way, about how much I'm going to do building on camera, I'm going to probably pause when we're doing big building projects. But when I'm talking about things, especially like, you know, the introduction to the campaign and why I'm doing certain things and what I'm deleting from the fortress, I'm going to talk while we build. Because I know that, you know, with a game that's very much about building, some people want to see the building and some people just want to see combat. It's a bit like Kerbal Space Program in that respect. Except, you know, Kerbal Space Program, people have seen building quite a lot. And From the Depths is, you know, still an early access game and it's been played a bit, but it isn't like massively widely known. So... I'll delete the glass for now, mainly because I'm not like got anything about against the glass. Just, I might be, like, putting a wall here that doesn't need glass. Especially if it's, you know, meant to be defending the engines. Because if the engines go, by the way, the fortress falls out the air, we die. We lose our fortress, game over. GG, thanks for playing. So, yeah, I will vary about how much I, you know, do building on off camera. If it's just something like building a hull, I'll build a lot of the hull off camera. Right, and I think what we should do is actually take down these wooden beams. Because I would like to defend my... Actually, I can just take it out from the bottom, can't I? I would like to defend my engine better. Because the engine is one of the things that needs to be defended, right? Ammo barrels? Your ammo stockpile? That would explode if hit. That is obviously a terrible, terrible thing to leave out and let get hit. Because you won't have any ammo. And you will actually then suddenly be like, yeah, my base has exploded in half. It's generally not the best thing to do. Also, the engine. If it goes, we lose a power to a lot of things, and especially the fortress starts to fall out of the air. So I am going to replace that. In fact, I might replace what it's in sitting on, because it's currently sitting on wood. And again, I don't really want it sitting on wood. That just seems like a terrible, terrible idea. I might do that. I might just move the entire thing back here, right next to the ammo stockpile. You know what? I'm going to do that. I'm going to do it. We'll delete these. These are the fuel containers, so I'll need to get more fuel containers. This is our fuel generator, and these are spare crates. Spares are used to, like, repair things. You have repair bots. And you can repair anything with spares. But you can't repair. You can't build stuff from it. Only, like, repair drones and stuff can do, I think. I think your repairs also use them. We'll delete this wall. Yeah, wooden walls? No. Not around the ammo stockpile. Too valuable for wooden walls. There we go. And I'll leave that wood floor for the moment, because I'm going to do a straight replace of that floor. So what we're going to do is we're just going to build an entire new engine section. Like, in situ, right? Where I want it. I don't have to fiddle about. And, ooh, I'm also going to set my colours up, because I've got a fleet main colour, which is the exact colour I want. And in fact, I might set fleet secondary for the floor, my white colour for the floor, and then blue can be like the walls. I don't know. I mean, it seems like a good idea. I'll do it. We'll see if it works out. And then the engine's going to be over here. So yeah, we're like entirely building our fortress again. So first thing to do is really get this engine in place. Once the engine's in place, I am pretty happy to put some weapons on this thing. And we probably do need to do that. In fact, I'm going to go out of build mode and check the map. No enemies nearby yet. They will be coming for me. Now, those of you who watched the stream the other day where we did a quick playthrough of this game, we didn't play through it. You know, we played a little bit. We had quite a time building. We had like 4 hours before an enemy came. And then they came in force, and we would have died. I actually had to do a boarding action to survive, and it was pretty hairy. I won't lie. I thought we could have died there. I really did think we were possibly dead. We came through. I'm amazing like that, you know, reliable. How much metal we've got left? 5,000. That's fine. And we'll put our engine in now. So I'm going to switch to, like, no tint for, like, components. Because I like seeing the texture of the components. Engine needs to point this way. Can I get the engine pointing the other way? Oh, I'm lowering and raising the fortress while I do this, aren't I? Yes. All right, I want you pointing the other way around, engine. Wait, that doesn't make a difference? Oh. Okay. Apparently engines always go this way around. How strange. Okay. Engine here. And then if we get our prefabs, I've got the prefabs set up. This is what I made earlier. It's a 5 by 3 by 2. And basically the 2 indicates that it's actually just too long, but I can make it longer. And basically every one I add adds more power. Now, it isn't working for some reason. I have to wonder why that is. Is it because we have no fuel? It could well be because we've got no fuel. So let's go to resources. Fuel storage tank. And we'll put a few fuel storage tanks here next to it. There we go. And a fuel processor. There we go. You're still not outputting power? Power. Current power output. Is the engine the wrong way around? Is that why? Engine number 9. Why are you... Because it's not putting out any power currently. Okay, let's delete this. My suspicion is that this is set up to go the other way around. Right, easy way to check. We build, like, a really minimal engine. So we go, like, engine here. And that's working, right? So if we put then a crankshaft. And then a cylinder. Maximum power output. Okay, so it is working, right? I really wish I could get the debris to disappear. We're going to go for prefab. 3-by engine. Rotate. Why is it not working? Why are you not giving me power? You should give me all the power. Right, so let me put this here, flip that around. Blocks, wood block. This is really confusing, right, the way. Really confusing. I'm going to put a mirror line down. And delete. Or P. There we go. Shrink all the blocks, right. One, two, three. One, two, three. And if I then... There we go. Now, here we got it. Like, look at that. Extra 200 power. It was the wrong way around. So prefab, 3x2 engine. Which way around is this 3x2 engine? That way around. Okay, so... Okay, you can hear that. The engine has changed. We've got a lot more power. So that's 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2. Do we have enough oil for that? Yeah, metal's a little bit low, but that's fine. Because if we go block, wood block, just any old block, right? Look at that. Almost 700 power. We had much less before. That's much more efficient. And that should be able to run us for quite a while. I will expand it, right? That's the great thing about the modular design, is I can expand it. Let's take this off and still plenty of power. We can expand quite a bit. So we're going to delete this. I really don't want this engine. It is bad, it is in the wrong place, and it is sitting on wood. So you will go away. Boom. Bye-bye. And you know what? This entire section here is made of wood. And I don't need that. I don't need that in my life. I do not need that in my life. Goodbye. You are the weakest link. Only my British viewers are going to get that. British viewers of a certain age, I guess. Is that even a show? I have no idea. So, night falls. No one's coming for us yet. They will. They will come for us. I need to, increase the wall height. I need to put more stuff under here. I think what we got to do quickly is actually increase the ammo storage area. And then put some defenses in, especially for the ammo storage area. I really don't want to be caught out and have my ammo storage exploded. And then be like, yeah, A, I have no ammo, and B, there's a gaping hole in my fortress. Because the one thing that we kind of need to keep going is a fortress. If we don't have a fortress, where will we respawn? I mean, you can respawn out of a fortress, but you need other stuff, right? We might not have other stuff in future. Especially since we currently have nothing. We deleted our starting boat. Because, I'm against boats or something. I don't know. It was awful. It wouldn't have done anything, really. It would have been like, yeah, I'm respawned, but I can't do anything. Right, we've got 6,000 ammo on board. That is fine for now. I will expand that later. Right. I don't think we have time in this episode to really start on anything really fancy, like a gun. So what I'm thinking is we just expand our resource collection. We've got plenty of oil. I could put another oil thingy in, but for now I'm not going to. What I will do is do a crystal farm. Now, we should have done that really at the beginning of the episode. So let's go resources and crystal growth farm. Right, so you have a base, and then you have, things you put on top. So put the crystal growth farm there, and then you see it says crystal to work with 45, maximum capacity 0, and then each crystal tray you put on top, that's a crystal growth farm. Let's cancel that and replace it with a crystal growth tray. Each crystal growth tray you put on top increases your capacity by 20. Yes, so we've got maximum capacity 60, and it can take 45, and you'll see that our crystals just ticked up 46. Come on, prove my point already. Like, it's a game mechanic. It's a thing. There we go. 47. And that's slowly, over time, going to tick up. That debris is just there looking at me going, why did you do this to me? And you see it's starting to despawn. Like, look at those. Those little holes. I didn't do those. Those are just, blocks slowly despawning. What else do I want? I think we're good. I think what we'll do is we'll put a missile system or a cannon, or a torpedo system up here. Now, I like torpedo systems. They're really efficient, really long range. But they can't hit anything out of the water. I mean, obviously, they're torpedoes. But, they're good. Missiles can hit pretty much anything except for really fast flyers, and they don't have much range. Cannons, pretty good. Cannons are pretty good all round, but you know they're having trouble hitting fast moving targets, etc. They're not quite as efficient in terms of ammo. But then again, you know, you can always shoot down missiles with laser systems if they have them. Although I don't think the nearby enemies have laser systems. If we go to build mode, map, can't see the enemy yet. But the nearby enemy in the beginning of the game are the Deepwater Guard, and they're probably the easiest enemy by quite a margin. So I think we'll end the episode here. Now, we haven't done that much. I mean, you say that. We've shorn our fortress in half, taken off the entire top bit and our defenses, and we've put an engine in here, which will last us for a little while, and we put metal down. But I've got high hopes. I've got high hopes for this series. People wanted to play a game. Frankly, I really want to play it myself. And I'm looking forward to this. But we're going to have to expand our base a little bit more. I think next time I'll start doing the pausing while I do big building projects. For things like guns, where I'm explaining all about the gun, I probably won't pause much, if at all. But when I'm doing, you know, some sort of big building process of, I've just got to build a new shed or whatever, I might do some pausing off camera. Pausing on camera and then, you know, do some stuff off camera. But yeah, until next time, I've been EnterElysium. If you liked, please remember to like and not subscribe, please consider subscribing. Really important, especially with a new series, and I really hope this will be a nice long series if people want it to be. As always, your support really does help show me how much you love me and how much you love the series. So if you love me, if you love the series, if you love the game, please give it a like. And that way, you know, I'll know that you want me to play lots and lots and lots and lots of it forever. Because frankly, I quite like to as well. I'm going to try and make this a daily series, but it does depend. You know, if I do a lot of stuff off camera, that's going to take a lot of time. And it might not be daily. So just be warned. I know people are going to ask me about that in future when I can't get every episode out daily. It might end up being like 2 a week if there are big projects towards the end. Like big building projects do take a lot of time. But we'll see. Anyway, until next time, stay shiny.